Today I am making a burrow for the SimmedUp save file. It is located in Glimmerbrook, which came with the Realm of Magic expansion pack. In this part of Glimmerbrook live the Grounders. Grounders were cursed for stealing potions during the Great Sickness. Hiding like rabbits, a sage turned them into those very animals. Shunned by other sims, grounders live in big families underground and form part of the burrow community. They collect, farm and often borrow from other sims, but always leave food as a thank you. They are forbidden to use magic and are very, very shy. So I made them a big house underground. The story that formed in my head when I was making this is that these two found grounders are newlyweds. They just moved out of their parents' home and they are ready to start a family for themselves. They got a lot of furniture from family members, and of course they borrowed some furniture from other sims, so the interior is a bit of a mismatch, which I thought was very cute. I wanted it to look like a burrow as much as possible. As you see, I have placed a round roof on the ground and I made it green to make it blend into the environment. The entrance is brown. I think it doesn't stand out that much. I will place some grass on top of it just to hide it away. And of course, I will place some rocks and some other landscaping just to make it blend into the environment more. It's not a point that it's very hidden, but it shouldn't stand out either. So I think I succeeded in that. You saw me place some debug plants in here too. Next to their burrow is a place where they can garden. I wanted them to be farmers. They grow their own food. They grow some fruit and vegetables. In the end of the speed build, you will see them plant some stuff. I made some dirt patches, so that's where they can plant all the stuff. I tried to place some grass on the roof, but the Sims wouldn't let me, so I just left it like this. It's by no means a starter home. It's not extremely expensive, especially for a build this size. I didn't go for the most expensive stuff, but it's not a starter home. But keep in mind those two Sims borrowed. Stole a lot of stuff that they placed in their home. The kitchen is entirely made from the kitchen kit we recently got. I thought it really fit in with the rest of the build. It's a bit run down and everything does work off the grid. Not all the lights I've got in here are off the grid, so it's not an off the grid home, but you could easily make it by replacing all the lights. And there is a computer here, you wouldn't be able to use that off the grid, but otherwise you are perfectly fine. I had some trouble figuring out what to put above the stove, but I went for a bit of a mismatch, and now I'm placing some clutter everywhere. Not too much, just so it looks a bit lived in. There are, I believe, 5 bedrooms and 3 bathrooms, so they have lots and lots of space for when the kids will come. You can easily sleep 8 Sims in here, especially if you're gonna use bunk beds. But even if you're gonna use single beds, some Sims might need to share a bedroom. This is the dining area. Like you see, it's a bit mismatched, which I really liked. This is the seating area. It's a bit small. I didn't really have that much space left for a sitting area, but I think it's look really, really cozy. And just it doesn't match. Everything in here doesn't match, and it isn't purpose. I thought that it just looked really nice. It looks like someone just moved in here. I mean, when I just got my my own home, we had a lot of stuff from the thrift store and some donations from family, and nothing really matched. Right now we got a lot of IKEA, so it does match right now. You see me put I put some wood on the floor. It's a bit rundown wood. I believe it's from one of those vacation packs. I forgot the name. And on the walls, it's actually it's some stuff that you usually put on the basement, but I thought because it was on the ground, it just looked right. I went with a bit of a rustic feel, so a wooden bed, a wooden side tables. And this is the master bedroom, and they have their own bathroom, their own ensuite. I thought that was nice, and they have the only computer in the house. It's a very simple desk with a chair, and I went with the cheapest computer in here because I don't think these Sims are very into computers and very into tech. There are more from living from the land, but you kind of need a computer for gameplay. That's why I included it. I really don't like the color of these tiles, but I thought they were just so perfect for this build. Just a bit run down and a bit ugly, actually. Yeah. And of course, when you are going to play in this, you can change up whatever you want. You can have your sim work to get more money, to get better stuff, better equipment. You can upgrade things. Now the toilets is one of the cheapest ones. So are the sinks. The shower works off the grid, by the way. And this shower too. I actually don't know if those toilets work off the grid. I'm not entirely sure. I think they do, but if you want the play of the grid, you should check it. This will be the nursery. I imagine their parents just donating some of the kids' stuff. Just like a subtle hint as to, yes, we want grandchildren, get on it. This is a changing table. Of course, you don't need it in The Sims, but I thought it would look nice with a bit of realism. I found some diapers in the debug menu, so I placed them on there. Unfortunately, they didn't stack. There's just two separate diapers in here and a waste bucket. And then I found this closet, and it was just too perfect not to use. Lots of linen in there, and I placed some blocks in there, and those canisters, I believe they are from Snowy Escape. They are supposed to be tea, but now they are baby powder, just so you know. And this is the guest bedroom, but in time it can of course become a kid's bedroom. For now it's for guests that want to stay. These two bedrooms I am not gonna furnish. They just have some clutter in them, some stuff they brought with them, they borrowed from other Sims, and they just didn't have other place to store. But of course they can be converted into actual bedrooms in time when they have kids. Now I'm gonna do some of the landscaping. The background has a lot of pine trees, so that's what I went with. And I am, I'm gonna make a pathway to the garden. And now I am gonna have those Sims plant all the stuff. I thought it looked so cute them working together in the garden. And here are the screenshots. I hope you liked this build. If you did, please press like, as it really helps me grow my channel. If you didn't know, I post new Sims 4 videos every day, so I hope to see you tomorrow. Bye bye!